Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Ladinna Amanda Sari from Offering I from Biology program. In this video, I will show you about a presentation, Seed in Space, and how well can they survive harsh non-Earth conditions. Will we someday colonize space? Will our children visit other planets? To achieve goals like this, we will need to crack one crucial challenge, how to feed ourselves for long periods away from Earth. A trip to Mars takes months. Exploring the galaxy will take even longer. Provision of nutritious food for travelers is a significant obstacle, while stockpiling food is an option, storing enough to last months during week. And space limitation in spacecraft and mission could easily outlast food shelf life. Growing food in space will be essential. Growing food in space is essential. Essential and not necessarily easy. The conditions in the vacuum of space are quite harsh compared to Earth. Seed in space must be able to withstand large doses of ultraviolet and cosmic radiation, low pressure and microgravity. Believe it or not, the first space travelers were seed. In 1946, NASA launched a V-2 rocket carrying corn seed to observe how they'd be affected by radiation. Since then, the scientific community has learned a great deal about the effect of the space environment on seed germination, metabolism, genetics, biochemistry, and even seed production. Astrobiologist David Tefer and Sidney Leach recently investigated how seed would be baked on Earth after spending extended period on the International Space Station. The experiment they conducted on Xbox mission were much longer than many other ISS seed experiments and placed the seed on the outside of the station in the depth of space rather than inside. The goal was to understand not only the effect of long-term radiation exposure, but a bit about the molecular mechanism of this effect. Seeds have some difference. Seeds possess a couple of remarkable traits that Tefer and Leach hypothesize will give these modern space travelers a fighting chance. One, kinetic redundancy and seed could contain flavonoids. First, they contain multiple copies of important genes, what scientists call genetic redundancy. If one genetic copy is damaged, there is still another available to do the job. Genetic redundancy is common in flowering plants, especially food products such as seedless watermelon and strawberries. Secondly, seeds contain semisalicylate flavonoid that act as sunscreen, protecting the seed DNA from damage by ultraviolet or UV light. On Earth, our planet atmosphere filters out some harmful UV light before it can reach us, but in space, there is no protective atmosphere. Will these special features be enough to let the seed survive or even thrive? To find out, Tefer and Leach conduct a series of experiments, both outside the International Space Station and back on Earth, with tobacco, Arabidopsis, is a flowering plant commonly used in research, and morning glory seeds. So this is the picture by NASA. The exposed art experiment attached to the exterior of the International Space Station. The Xbox E experiment flew to the International Space Station, or ISS, in 2010 and lasted 558 days, so just under 2 years. They stored the seed in a single layer on the outside of the ISS behind a special kind of glass that let in ultraviolet radiation only at wavelength between 110 and 400 nanometers. DNA readily absorbs UV radiation in this wavelength range. A second, identical set of seed was on the ISS, but separated completely from UV radiation. The purpose of this experiment design was to observe the effect of UV radiation separately from other types of radiation, like cosmic rays that are everywhere in space. Xbox A. Temper and leads choose tobacco and adaptive seed for toxic because have a redundant genome and therefore good odds for survival. They also include a genetically engineered variety of tobacco with an antibiotic resistant gene adept. The plan was to later test in this gene the bacteria and determine if there was any damage. In addition to normal Arabic disease, they sent up to genetically modified strain of the plant that contain low and absent UV protective semi-cells in their seed core. They also sent purified DNA and purified flavonoid. This gave the researcher a wide range of scenarios by which to understand the effect of space on the seed. This is the picture of Arabidopsis plant, maturing silico and flower and pollen grain. Xbox R. A second ISS mission called Xbox R includes only the three types of Arabidopsis seed. This reserve a little over double the dose of ultraviolet light because of the longer experiment time. Lastly, research performed a ground experiment back in the lab that exposed Arabidopsis, tobacco, and glory seed to fake doses of UV light for only a month. After all this various exposure, it was time to see where the seed could grow. So this is the picture by NASA. The Xbox R experiment was equipped with three trays containing a variety of biological samples, including seed. What would researchers read? When the seed returned to Earth, the researchers measured their germination rate. The seed that had been shielded in the lab did the best, with more than 19% of them germinating. The seed that had been exposed to UV radiation for a month in laboratory with better than 18% germinating. For the space traveling seed, more than 16% of the shielded seeds germinated, a mere 3% of space UV exposed seed did. The 11 Arabidopsis plant that did grow from both the wild type and genetically engineered seed didn't survive. One plant in soil. Tobacco plants, however, saw a reduced growth, but that growth rate recovered in subsequent regeneration. Tobacco has a much healthier seed core and a more redundant genome, which may explain its apparent survival advantage. The bacteria test. When the researcher put the antibiotic resistance gene into bacteria, they found it was still functional after its trip to space. The findings suggest it's not genetic damage that making these seeds less viable. Therefore, and leads attribute the reduced germination rate to damage to other molecules in the seed besides DNA, such as protein. Rather than genome or built-in DNA repair mechanism were not going to overcome that damage, further explaining why the Arabidopsis plants didn't survive transplanting. So, in the ground experiment, the researcher found that radiation damage is dose dependent. The more radiation the seed receives, the worse the germination rate. These discoveries could inform future direction for research in space agriculture. Scientists may consider genetically engineering seeds to have added protection for the cellular machinery critical for protein synthesis, such as ribosomes. Future research, we also need to explore further how seeds start in space germinate in microgravity rather than on Earth. Our researchers add to the knowledge of how space affects plants and their seeds. We can continue to make the strides necessary towards producing food in space, will be a crucial step forward sustainable colonies that can survive beyond the comfortable confines of Earth's biosphere. So that's all my presentation about life in space and how well can they survive harsh conditions. Thank you for watching this video. I'm Ladinna Sari. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.